Once upon a time, in a faraway land, a young prince was cursed by an enchantress, transformed into a horrible beast. Doomed was he until he met a fair maiden that could see the beauty within him, as the chase to slay him drew close.
Oh, wait. You thought I was talking about this Beauty and the Beast? No. That would be a good movie. No, today I bring you a very different tale. One that I found while trying to find the Disney animated classic online for free when karma struck. The 2009 version, directed by David Lister and distributed by the creepy horse that is Barnholtz Entertainment. Anyways, it's a live-action fantasy movie that throws out the idiotic ideas of charming characters or a good story, and instead gives us a grim, murderous, and probably the funniest reimagining only suitable for the Siffy channel, in which a troll attacks people, and Estella Warren has top billing. Sound bad enough for you? Well, trust me, you'll want to see this. You'll want to see this tale as old as shit.
You all know the lovely old legend of Beauty and the Beast. I used to be the law around here. Sheriff Otto, they called me. And I knew the Beast. And I'm telling you that what really happened was far, far more terrifying than anything the storytellers ever admitted.
You have no idea how ironic that statement is. All right, people, this is what really happened. Not that lame little cartoon with the dancing cutlery chorus lines and the silly songs and shit. No, I don't know what you kids were smoking, but this is the real deal. This is the true epic that is B&B, A Dark Tale. The story starts in a CG castle in the land of where the king is dying and the successors of the throne have gathered. One of these things is not like the other. One of these things doesn't belong. Can you tell which thing is not like the other? One of these things is evil.
You shan't forget it again.
Sold. This is Rudolph the Ruthless, our antagonist of the movie, if you couldn't tell. He's like this version's Gaston, so I'm gonna call him that since Rudolph is a stupid name. He wants to be king and is probably gay. Watching from afar is our second antagonist, Helen the Witch. A name striking fear into the hearts of men. She's chilling in her tower with her evil lair decorum from the Rita Repulsa collection, concocting bubble flesh soup? No, really, she's creating a creature so horrible, it raises from a cauldron of shit. This is what we're in for, folks. Blood and gore effects I've seen done better at my local zombie run.
Little town, it's a quiet village. Every day, like the one before. Little town, full of little people.
At the cleaner woman's house, we meet Belle, a blonde bimbo who's into herb mixing, climbing trees, and getting her clothes from mooncostumes.com. Man, she has really given that pestle a hand job.
Oh, I guess this one could use some work.
She really is a funny girl, that Belle.
Mother, it's all trial and error. Besides, I'll go out and get some herbs for a new combination.
You're not going out now.
At least put some pants on. So she frolics the woods for more ingredients in her flamboyant pink miniskirt and brown vinyl corset thrown over it. I mean, jeez, she's like the Bizarro World version of Disney's Belle. And no one else in the entire film dresses this way. It's so bad. Also, what's with her lip? Did collagen just sneak in? Suddenly, she is stalked and attacked by a wolfskin, slain by an arrow of instant rigor mortis.
You can't see me. No, what are you doing? I'm invisible. Go away!
She comes face to face with the son of Tanning Mom? He fires a warning shot and Belle flees or something. Meanwhile, Gaston and his lackeys are scheming.
Let me put you this way. I want you to start recruiting more men.
But my lord, we can't afford any more extras.
When something wicked this way comes.
I was impressed with how decisively you dealt with Duke Edward, Rudolph.
Duke Edward's death was nothing more than an unfortunate accident.
Come on. I have ways of seeing these things, you know that.
That's right, I forgot. You dabble in witchcraft.
Forgot? Asshole, she just popped out of thin air with cloaks and robes. I think remembering someone like that would be top priority.
Witchcraft? That can help you reach the throne.
And why would you do that? What could possibly be in it for you?
The fact that I would also like to be on the throne. As your queen.
Excuse me.
I don't know why he's making such a fuss about this. She's powerful, smart, and she's the hottest actress in this movie. More than Barbie over here. And so what if she's your cousin? In this time in fiction, royalty was doing that shit all the time. Look at the Lannisters over here. Dude, tap that ass, bro.
I'll get the throne without your help, my lady.
This is why I think he prefers men.
Think about my offer, Rudolph. Think about the pleasure I can give you, and the power, and what I might do if you spurn me.
Lady Helen.
Nice take there. Standing in the bushes is Belle, surprised that she was caught while wearing bright pink.
The beast tried to kill me.
The beast is nothing more than a legend. You've let your imagination run away with you, young lady.
Do I look like an idiot?
Don't answer that.
The beast killed a wolf right in front of my eyes with a crossbow, and then he tried to kill me.
Crossbow? That's the weapon that the beast is supposed to use.
But of course! An inhuman monster like him would be dastardly enough to not use his claws or fangs, but use a weapon instead! Unfortunately, the script says that Gaston is into Belle, and they get this weird banter with each other.
How often does a washerwoman's daughter get the chance to be intimate with a lord? You should feel flattered.
Problem is, I don't, so get your lecherous hands off me.
You need a lesson in manners, wench.
And you need a lesson in common courtesy.
Oh, Gaston, she can't love you the way your serving boys do.
Ah! His head!
Oh, wow, he sure made it far without having a head. Did someone shove a stick up his ass? The chase is on for the horrible creature as it heads to the village.
Bonjour!
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 Bonjour.
The beast, he's gone through the window, sir.
Get the people out!
Old tank!
Somebody going after the beast. Move it!
The Roar Jerker!
Intro Sheriff Otto, our narrator and feeble old guy of the story.
What happened? You look as though you've seen a ghost.
They're gonna kill him.
Police? Isn't that a good thing?
He never did anybody any harm.
Otto, I saw him tear a man's head right from his body.
You saw it?
I saw the body.
How do you know the beast was responsible?
Yeah. You guys just said the beast was infamous for using a crossbow. Why the hell would he rip someone's head off? Also, I think Otto's having a heart attack. It's too bad about the doctor. Well, anyone? Oh, for God's sake, help the guy out!
The beast has killed the doctor.
Oh, it can't be him.
Fire into the window! Fire!
you shot me! You shot me right in the chest! I can't believe you assholes missed! What the fuck's wrong with you? Didn't we have any training? Smooth move, guys.
I don't know. What's the matter?
I have to.
You have to what?
Check my blood sugar levels.
Gaston, with a blood vengeance, sends out his 20 LARPers to scour the land in search of the beast. Belle, on the other hand, decides to go on a quest to learn of the beast, with her only clue being a crossbow bolt and the worst map in the world. Oh my god. Oh no. No. You can't be serious. Hey, Greg, do you have that map we need for filming today? What? That was today? I thought it was supposed to be due next week. Shit, Greg, we need that map in like 2 hours. Okay, calm down. I got this. Just give me some paper, coffee, shears, and charcoal, and I'll get it done by then. We're cool. Oh, right, the quest. So she bounds through the woods and climbs trees while avoiding Gaston's forces, who I'm guessing are colorblind and pretty stupid. I guess if Naruto can get away with a jumpsuit, to each their own. Hey, are those mountains giving me the finger? Belle reaches the end of the dotted line on her piece of toilet paper. A ruin. Sprinkled out front with decorative carcass. Looks safe enough. And hey, there's like 5 minutes worth of flashback of everything I'd just seen! Neat. Is that a handrail vine? Because I would say safety first, but this is the setting for a medieval slasher flick.
Is anybody here?
No! Make yourself a home! I've got plenty of carcass to share and stuff!
Thank God it's not porn.
Otto sent me.
Oh, sorry, I meant to say salutations.
Sheriff Otto, in the village.
Otto.
Oh, it's not pronounced Otto, it's pronounced Otto. Silly me. So Belle and the Beast have a chat, but since there's so much latex foam on this poor guy's face, he can barely even pronounce some words.
And then you turned and fired your crossbow at me. Why would you do that?
To make you go away. I did not want you to see me!
I didn't get to clean up, all my carcasses are out of place, I didn't dust off my bone collection, it's a mess in here!
I saw Dr. Thorne torn apart.
I killed to eat. Only to eat!
And decorate!
Ask Otto.
Otto said you didn't kill them. But he's sick. He's very ill. That's why I came.
Asian flute alarm? So the LARPers are on the way when the beer goggles strike. Beast thinks that Belle's a traitor and furiously locks her away in a makeshift prison of sticks.
Stay here! Don't move!
Please. No! You've got it all wrong! No!
What is with the Asian flute?
TPK! TPK!
It's so rubbery!
Motherfucker!
You take 2 points of damage!
Noobs! My kingdom for a cleric!
Dots! More dots! Dots! More dots!
The Beast arrives to witness the bane of our story. The giant mutant, Naked Mole Rat. Actually, it's the troll, and while the CG in this movie looks pretty... meh, it definitely looks better than the rubber suit that pwned the LARPers. Belle escapes by... using the latch. So this is the worst cell anyone could have made. I don't know what's worse, the Beast making a prison out of sticks, or the sad fact that Belle took so long to get out of the cell made of sticks.
God, no.
Lady, you didn't have an accent before. Don't try to pull one out of your ass now.
Does this look like my work?
I have style when I decorate my corpses.
Belle and Beast come to a common ground while Gaston and his men trek the fairgrounds as we cut to this commercial break.
What's your name?
Beast.
No, that's just what they call you. What's your real name?
Matilda.
So B&B share the night while a plot point pops up. Beast favors a design on a chalice he's had for years.
What is this pattern around the rim?
My pattern.
You're very clever.
Unlike this script.
I have a lot of time on my hands in the winter. When the wind howls and the snow falls, I sit by the fire and carve.
I also play bass for Megadeth.
Back at Castle Flimsy, someone's having a hissy fit.
Second goblin. Quiet!
There's something next to you, my lord. Maybe a massage would help?
Get out.
Aw, poor guy. Hey, I know what would cheer you up.
No! No one's got a swell cleft in his chin like Gaston.
Out for a stroll on the, I don't know, styrofoam terrace? Black magic woman crossfades in again.
The hell are you doing here?
I've come to soothe you.
Dude!
I understand you've had a very trying afternoon.
What the hell could you know about my day?
You tweeted it, of course.
Also, she's a fucking witch! How do you keep forgetting this? So she reveals that the one responsible for the murders is her troll.
A vicious, maniacal killing machine controlled only by me.
Straight from the pits of 4chan.
With a little help from this.
Tears of grief.
Here's the deal. Either Gaston here plays along or else Helen will keep him from the throne. Trolling him, if you will. Blonde and Bumpy make their way to find a new hiding place when— Oh no! Belle's been spotted! I'm shocked! She's been the master of subtlety so far. Helen and Gaston are straight up thugging at the castle, eating what looks like 7 grapes and a slice of bread from the whole feast. Great to be the 1% and all, as Belle is dragged in for questioning.
You know this woman, Count?
She's the one who alerted us to the beast's rampage. Then had objections when I took her with me to go find it.
What I objected to was you fondling me like some lecherous old goat.
Well, I like lecherous old goats.
And you saw the beast? I said, did you see the beast? I have nothing to say to you.
Good. Good.
Then she makes her talk to the hand for HD mind reading.
Is that possible?
She actually thinks?
No, Helen is freaked out by the beast as Zombie Belle is dragged away.
Chain her properly.
Look at her, sir. She's aware of the fairies.
Stop! Away with the fairies!
Duped by a 110-pound blonde in a miniskirt. Nice work, guys! Belle on the run finds a royal skin with the pattern of the beast at the top. Well, gee, I wonder what that means. She slips out the window and hangs from a ledge like an American gladiator. She overhears Helen warn Gaston that the beast is the lost son of the dying king of and has the right to the throne. With a hair of the beast found on Belle, the witch casts a telepathic warning to him.
By thorn and by root, by blade and by chalices, I call upon that from which this comes.
What page is that under?
It's up to you, beast. Go to her house in the village. Save
me. Well, I've got nothing better to do.
Yeah, while the beast gets to that, Belle managed to escape. Again. Seriously? Okay, so these guys failed to rescue someone, shot a dozen bolts of friendly fire into a guy, completely missed the blonde chick wearing a pink miniskirt in the woods, got mutilated by a rubber troll suit, and then let that same unrestrained woman escape with the lamest of guises. Apparently, all that's necessary to join Gaston's army is to have a pulse and a penis. No past work experience necessary at all. Belle climbs up another tree and feels safe enough to sleep. I guess I would too if I was being chased by these dumbasses. The next morning, Beast heads over to the village, but he's not alone as the troll seeks another innocent victim, Belle's mom. While Belle apparently fell off the tree in her sleep. Well, she's a deep sleeper, I can tell you that.
There's a monster trying to kill you, and it's not me!
Who's there? Who is it?
He's coming to get you! You have to trust me!
Sir Derpala and Scary Spice arrive to... watch.
Barrels and chairs! My one weakness!
And that's all she was hired for.
I'm here to save you! Aw, oh, damn it!
Fucking noob!
Well, it looks like the guards did something right. But, how lame is it that they could catch the Beast, but lose Belle? My god, this woman is covered in cherry syrup. Gaston is about to stab the Beast for solo XPs, and then Otto pops up. Wait, what?
Of course, sir. As soon as the trial is over, we'll be singing your praises.
Trial?
Put these on him.
Of course, Otto.
What trial? We caught the Beast red-handed.
A fucking objection! There's no blood on the Beast's hands! His hands are literally not red! Otto pulls King's Law out from under the rug, and a trial will be held in witness of the villagers. All 20 of them. Belle arrives too little too late to see the attack, and again mistrusts the Beast for him being in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Sorry, Belle. It appears the Beast has killed your mother.
No!
It was only my regard for the law that stopped me from killing her on the spot.
Let me pass! I need to see her!
She worked so hard.
And stuff.
She worked so hard for me.
And I didn't even know her name.
Oh, man! If only this cell were made of sticks!
If I kill you now, the movie will be over. Get it? 'Cause the Beast used a crossbow, and then he was almost killed by one! Full circle! What am I doing? To comfort Belle, Atta tells her the story of the Beast, how the king was all up into Helen, but then found a wife and had a son. Helen got pissed and cursed the thing, making King Asshole send it into the woods, with Atta's mercy being the one to raise the little abomination.
As I got to know him, I realized that beneath that horrible exterior was one of the kindest, gentlest beings I have ever known.
Oh, you mean the guy that decorates his house with carcasses, locks maidens into cells, breaks into people's houses, and keeps yelling to everyone. Oh yeah, he's a real softy. Belle and Atta then walk over to the Beast's cell to teach him of his true birthright, as Corella over here...
Damn her eyes. Why didn't that fool Rudolph get rid of him when he could? And why didn't I get rid of her?
Yeah, that was pretty stupid on your part. But you're still hotter than her, if that counts.
So you shouldn't be in this jail cell. You should be in the royal palace, acclaimed as the next king. It's true. Don't you believe it?
I believe you. I believe Otto. But who else will believe?
If Helen used sorcery, if she cast a spell, perhaps it could be broken.
Broken?
Well, in the stores, it's usually something.
Stores?
What?
Come here.
Tale as old as time. True as it can be. Barely even friends. Then somebody bends unexpectedly. Just a little change.
You taste like old jerky.
When was the last time you bathed?
Does bathing in filth count?
You kissed me.
I was trying to break the spell.
Awkward. Anyways, news spreads that the king is dead, and by that, I mean some guy is yelling it off stage. Belle, though, tries to think of a plan. Or about anything.
Calm down, we're just trying to give you a haircut.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Following orders.
We're trying to make him look good for the trial.
I am the sheriff here. And I will not let you do that.
It's on account of you we're doing it.
What?
The beast attacked you.
What are you talking about? Of course it didn't attack me.
Oh, yes, he did.
And that happens. Belle has escaped, though, in spite of the corrupt trial about to begin.
It's a beast. He's got fangs, razor sharp ones. Massive paws, killer claws for the feast. Oh. Hear him roar, see him foam, but we're not coming home till he's dead. Good and dead! Kill the beast!
Members of the jury, have you reached a verdict?
Is the beast guilty or not guilty of the death of the washerwoman Anna?
What is with Grandma's hair?
Guilty, my lord.
Quiet! Quiet!
Then I hereby announce.
You're fucking vexing me. Yes. Before Gaston can let the axe fall on the beast, Belle heroically throws a smoke bomb on the executioner's deck, like a freaking ninja. I wish I was kidding about this, but it works, and they escape. Again.
No!
Helen is not pleased. Time to bring out the troll again.
Justice having failed, troll, it's time to set you loose again. This time, it's the beast. Oh. I know, he's stronger than you and almost as ugly. But would you like some of this?
Crystal Pepsi?
Okay, I know I'm harping on this chick a lot, but for reals, she's awesome. She's the best roleplayer among them and would probably play a mean game of Dungeons and Dragons.
And a lot of other roleplaying, if you know what I mean.
Next plan? Have the troll use a dagger coated in petrifying potion on the beast, casting a texture effect and turning him to stone. Have the troll use a dagger rather than just maim him with his claws. His rubbery, flimsy, latex claws. Okay, all right. What do I know?
She glanced this way, I thought I saw. And when we touched, she didn't shudder at my paw. No, it can't be, I'll just ignore. But then she's never looked at me that way before.
B&B plan to burn the witch that night, but Beast has a political problem.
You think the people would take me as their king?
No. Probably not.
Then why should I do it?
Because it's the right thing to do, and because I hope that you care for this land and the people in it.
The people who shunned me. The people who spat at me. The people who wanted to kill me.
Well, it could be worse. You could be Rush Limbaugh.
You ask a lot, Bill.
And you have a lot.
Troll attack! Horsey, no!
Are you all right?
Yes, he didn't touch me. But I've decided something.
Yes.
The witch must die.
And so they venture to raid the evil lair.
What? You gibbering stupid fool!
Oh my god, I'm sorry. She's just...
I gave you the best dagger ever made and you...
You know what? No, I'm not sorry.
No more until I say so. Get in the cage.
Man, this is bullshit! Screw you, lady, I'm gonna go back to YouTube!
We interrupt your divination to give you this assault to your livelihood. Be sure to avoid all bonfires, buckets of water, and all anti-magic paraphernalia. This is not a drill.
To the killing zone, beast.
Lightning bolt! Lightning bolt! Lightning bolt! Lightning bolt!
Another not very smart idea, having geometric shapes on the side of your fortress, leading straight into your lair, making it easy for someone to climb up and kill you.
Spare me. And I'll turn you back into the prince you really are. Now, isn't that a wonderful bargain?
You're evil!
Quite true. But, you see this? These came from your head when you were still human. I used them against you. And I also used them to give life to my troll.
The troll is my brother?
Take me back now, or you die!
I'm sorry I don't respond well to threats. In fact, I hate them.
Oh, right in the latex!
About to finish the job, Belle comes to the rescue. And fails.
What a perfect morning this has become. I get to kill the beast and slit the throat of his beloved all in one morning.
Fatality.
How dare you!
Best part of this movie. I guess you could say she came out ahead of everyone else.
With the beast dying and red dye 40 pouring out of his wounds, Belle quickly takes some random paste and shoves it into him.
Oh, stop! Stop! You're not helping!
Magically healed! Then we get this crap again.
We've really needed you at home.
No one needs me.
Yes, we do. You're the king.
Nala, we've been through this. I'm not the king. Look, sometimes bad things happen.
Simba.
And there's nothing you can do about it. So why worry?
Because it's your responsibility. Don't you understand? You're our only hope.
Listen, you think you can just show up and tell me how to live my life? You don't even know what I've been through.
I would if you just tell me.
Disney is so going to sue me.
Back in the village, Gaston has the troll and the townsfolk by the balls and asserts his authority over the village and the last remaining in line for the throne. Yeah, that's nice and all, but, you know, there's one guy I can't help but notice completely steal the show. See him? The guy with the orange hat. He's trying so hard to be in this movie.
I love you, Crayon Head.
Gaston is about to take the title when... Uh-oh! The Beast and Belle are caught!
Not until we're finished, Count!
You see before you the rightful heir to the throne.
How can that be possible?
Are you mad, Beast?
No. I am Maximilian the 14th, son of Maximilian 13th.
Who in the world do you think is gonna believe such a foolish story?
Well, he's doing better than most Republican campaigns so far.
Anyone with an eye for the truth, Rudolph. Anyone who knows you is the cruel, grasping usurper that you are. Someone like me, for example.
I realize that beneath that horrible exterior was one of the kindest, gentlest beings I have ever known.
Oh yeah, the perfect heir to the throne.
Troll attack part deux!
You'll leave her. You won't harm her. But only if you renounce any claim you have to the throne.
It's touching me. It smells worse than the beast.
So what can our noble beast do? Does he forsake the kingdom for the one he loves? Or does he claim his birthright in her sacrifice?
I hereby renounce all claim.
The hell you do.
Pop a cap in his ass.
Pierced by Helen's potion, Gaston reverts to his true acting nature. Boring as a rock.
Well,
Fuck this, I'm out of this film!
With the curse finally broken, the beast turns back into whatever the hell this is.
I proclaim the start of the reign of your new monarch. Yes. Maximilian XIV.
We're easily amused!
We accept you now that you're attractive!
All hail King Matilda!
Yes, a man who was raised in the wild since birth, has no understanding of etiquette or politics, and decorates his house with deer carcasses. Still, a better candidate than some Republicans.
You still taste like jerky.
And at last, a final message from Atta.
He did exactly what he promised. As long as that couple ruled, there was peace, there was prosperity, and there was also two very unusual statues, just to remind people how lucky they were.
And remember, that is what really happened. What a load of shit. Honestly, though, I really do like this movie. I remember back when I saw this for the first time and couldn't even believe it existed. That this had a budget, that this had a DVD, which I bought almost instantly. The acting is awful, but not really lazy. The setting is cheap, but still attractive. And the story sucks. Oh, does it suck! But it's not the reason for watching it. It's a hilariously bad movie that is worth watching once a year and with friends who've never seen this before. As I said before, trust me, you'll want to see this. I'm Joe Cassidy, and if you excuse me, I've got a beast to find. Damn it, Lumiere! We're lost because of your stupid map!
Shit. It's fucking cold.